Welcome back to American's Truck Simulator with the Rude Man. And last episode, we picked up our new truck. We got a new driver, so everything's looking up. Let's take a look and a little refresher on who we hired. Our Fresno shop, truck maintenance minus $5,000, driver's pay minus $32,000, fuel for drivers minus $7,000, profit 116 out of 161 revenue, average daily profit. Well, we're making a little bit of money. That's our new driver there. Did I give her any training? Let's see. No, she's unbalanced. I don't want her unbalanced. Oh, wow. She's already got a tag for hazardous driving or hauling. I don't want her unbalanced. Let's put her on long distance for now. So, yeah, she's a rookie. She's only got... How'd she get that? She's got the tag for explosives. Well, we'll put her on long distance, and then let's see. How's Merrick doing? He's still on hazardous. So... he's got two of them. He's got his flammable. So he's got two. All right, he's got two of those. Let's put him on. Let's get him an extra. Let's get him an extra one of these. That was high value. Let's put him back on high value for a little while. And how are we doing? We've got three of those, two of those. Yeah, we're looking good. So let's get on with our first job of the evening. So first of all, it's a brand new truck. Maybe I better check and see if I need... I shouldn't need... Oh, I never got any sleep. I couldn't figure out why I couldn't sleep at this show. All those trucks are gone. They were hogging up all the space. Ooh, a sleeper. Doesn't look like a very comfortable one. Yeah, so why couldn't we sleep here? All right, let's see if we can find the sweet spot for sleeping. Oh, I have a brake on. It says on the map that I can sleep here. But when we bought our truck, this place was just full of parked trucks. So why couldn't we sleep? Isn't that odd? I thought for sure it had to sleep. Oh, the sleep sign is on the other side of the lot. Okay. That kind of explains that. I think I was extra excited about getting my new truck. And now I'm going to have to remember this is a 13 speed, so we've got extra gears to deal with. Okay, has that guy got the only sleeping spot? Or is that one behind me there? I think it is. Right there. Directly behind me. I don't want to sleep in the day. Yeah, there's one right here. I don't want to sleep my daylight away. I'm driving at night. Okay, do I have to be facing the other direction? Nope, there we go. Alright, let's get some shut-eye before we take a job. Alright, it's 9 o'clock at night. Driver Merrick made a little money. And Reese made a little money. Hey, they're just making money left and right. Uh-oh. They took a payment. My payment's down, though. It was $8,000. Now it's down to $7,000. Okay, so we're ready to go pick up a job. So let's go in and see what kind of job we can get. Righty. We are in Bakersfield. Best job or highest paying job we can get is to Eureka. Have we been to Eureka? No, we have not. I thought we had. I thought we'd been to Eureka, but it doesn't show like we have. Well, that's odd, because, Well, there you go. We have 11 hours to pick this up, so let's go ahead and take it. It's fragile, it's high value, and it's an important delivery. So let's go set our GPS and pick it up. All right, now I gotta remind myself, I've got 13 gears now. So let's start out second, get out of here. Now notice the GPS on the dashboard in this truck is closer to the wheel. The other one was farther away. But I don't need both GPS's, so I can't remember what I did to shut those off. It's not that. Gotta get used to my new truck. Did I have a key that I was using? All right, won't worry about it right now. Let's see, we need to go to the right. Yeah, I think this truck's got a little more power to it too. Palm trees and blue skies, you gotta love it. Cause it's rainy as all get out where I live. Oh my God, I just looked at the weather last night. We got three or four different storms coming in with just a few hours in between, from a few hours to a day between them in the next week and a half. Pleasant weather. Rainy, windy, just nasty. At least it's not that cold. It's going to be in the 50s. So as low as some of the like mid 40s at night. It's not too bad. You got a little truck on the side there. California, gotta love it. Uh-oh, I'm speeding already. Oh geez, I gotta merge. Is this guy in the back of this tanker going to give me a break? Yeah, he is. Thank you. I'd honk at you, but... No, still got that damn cheesy horn. God, I can't wait to get more experience, to get to upgrade my horn to an air horn. I didn't check any of that when I was there. But I don't want to do it right now. I just want to get on the road. Haven't been on the road for a week. It's time to travel. You know, that's kind of the way it goes. You know, to be a truck driver, you know, I was never very good. I was not a good truck driver. And what I mean by that is I didn't have the temperament for it. I didn't have the... I just didn't have... what you kind of need to have to be a truck driver, and that is the family that I have that were truck drivers. They would get home, and the whole time they're home, instead of really enjoying the fact that they were home, they were concentrating on getting ready for the next trip, and they were just antsy all the time. They wanted to hit the road again, and that's kind of what it takes to be, a truck driver. You're kind of like a nomad, if you will. So if we run through the gears, we got first and third. See, we got a one and two in the one position, then two and three, four and five, 6, 7, and 8 and 9, and then up to 10, 11, 12, and 13. So I know that didn't make any sense. I can't really run through it while I'm on the highway, so I'll bring this subject up again when I get a chance. Oh, crap. I have stuck myself on a hill. Okay, we still have a splitter that we use. I'm in first, second. And then you go down to third and fourth. Then you go up to 6 and 7. Down is 8 and 9. And then you shift back up into the first position for 10, 11, and then down in the second position for 12 and 13. So at this position I'm at right now, I would split up. I'd hit my splitter and pop up. So we got a fuel tank is full, our sleep is full. So we should be all set to take off. Is this the rail station?
I've been working on a railroad.
Yeah, not. It'd be pretty good paying jobs though. Railroad jobs. You know what the good paying jobs are? The stevedores or the longshoremen. Whoop! Missed my turn. That's what I get for rubbernecking. That's our piece of equipment right there, you want to bet? Hey, there's a train going by. Cool beans. All right, let's take a peek at what we have. There's our job right there, forklifts. And that is our trailer. I kind of thought it was. So let's see here. Let's pull in over here. I've yet to use the high-speed reverse. There's two speeds of reverse. All right, we've got our load. Let's take a look at what we have. Okay, so forklift, 17,000 pounds. It's a light load. Going to Eureka to Walbert's. We're expected there by Friday, no later than 2:17 p.m. So we got about a day and a half. We're making 14,000, and let's see, we're gonna have to sleep about 10 hours from now, so we better hit the road. At least it's a light load. I like these mirrors better than the ones I had on the old truck. Yeah, those were kind of cheesy. They look like antennae for a grasshopper or something, those ones I had. These are a little shorter and more square and got a little color to them. Hope the railroad's train is gone. All right, let's head it this way. Any traffic? I can't see around those bushes. There we go. All right, we're okay. Bam! That's what I was expecting. Oh, we're okay. Famous last words. Like, hey, watch this. Yeah, right. Alright, I can't wait. I can't wait to get used to this 13 speeds. Got a little bigger engine too, so that should help. Say about more power? Come on. You can do it. I think I can. I've been this way before. Those cactus look familiar. Stop, get me a taco or a burrito. How about a hamburger? Cheeseburger and fries. Right, I'm coming in. Oh, geez. Maybe not. Walberts. Hey, I'm going to Walberts. We might be related. I thought I just got fined for speeding or something. I hate that sound. It's scary. It scares me. All right. 10th gear. Two more to go, but I'm already doing 55, so I don't want to speed. Can't afford the tickets. Man, I've lost more money on tickets. Can't wait for them to open up Arizona. That's going to be fun. I've never been to Arizona. I've driven truck in California, Oregon, Washington, California, and Calgary, Canada, but I've never been to Arizona before. I've always kind of wanted to go to New Mexico. My mom was born in New Mexico, and I've always kind of wanted to go visit. She passed when I was 6 years old. Actually, I was only about 5 when she actually passed. And I've always kind of wanted to go and see where she was from. I didn't know very much about her. I don't remember much about her. I don't remember anything actually. Oh, jeez. I don't remember anything actually. I wonder why he slammed his brakes on like that. Well, we're just cruising right along in 10th gear. We do have a little more power. It's got a light load. A little more power. We got a couple extra gears. But can't use them because speed's only 55. 55, stay alive. Look, it's a little shack on the prairie. Yeah, there's a way to mod your trailers along with your truck, but I don't quite know how that would work because you don't have the same trailer every load. So I don't know what that would do for you. It would kind of be, well, actually, if you modded a trailer or two, it would give you the opportunity to have a little bit more variety in what you're hauling. So that might be kind of fun. I might try doing that. I haven't had any time. If I can get a little bit more time, I want to play with my mod that I'm using on my truck. Like maybe add some flames to it or something a little bit more to it. Snazz it up a little bit. I added some flames to it just for a test, but I forgot to make the flames transparent. And they had a white background, so that looked a little cheesy. So I'll have to work on it. It just takes a lot of time. And for me, you know, I'm not real used to the software, so it's kind of trial and error. What does this do? How would I make it do that? You know, that kind of thing. You thought I was going to hit that guy, didn't you? Of course, I did too, so. Oh, I missed that one. Good food week at Stockton. What do we got around here? What's about? Ooh, there's a Groisman and an Enhul. Instead of U-Hauls, Enhul. What's going on out there? Better watch, I'm gonna miss my light. Almost did. Yeah, it's a question that came up from somebody, I don't remember who it was telling me that I'm skipping gears. Because if you notice, I just went from second to fourth, to six to eight. Skipping gears, and they ask why do you skip so many gears? Yeah, there's nothing says you have to start off in first gear. If you don't have, you know, a lot of weight and you can get away with starting out in second gear, you should, because if you try to start off in first gear and there's no reason for you to be in first gear, you know, like if you're climbing a hill or starting with a really, really heavy load and you need to get, you know, a start. What it's going to do, it's going to over-torque your truck. You're starting in too low a gear. So, you basically only use the gears you need. If you're pulling good enough and you can jump, you know, from 4 to 6, then more power to you. Yeah, I know you're not supposed to, but hell, there's half the time I'd shift without even using the clutch. If you know, time the gears right, it's, I've done that a lot. I don't think you're supposed to, but oh shoot, I'm gonna get. Is this where the oh, I thought the. Oh, it did. Speed limit dropped to 35. You just don't have much of a warning there either. So anyway, yeah, there's nothing says you have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, all the way to 13. It's just, you know, you use the gear you need. Go through Anaheim and see Disney World or Disneyland. That'd be cool. LA's kind of funny. You can be driving through LA. You don't know when you get out of it. Really. I mean, I've looked around and said, oh, we're in Anaheim. How in the hell did we get in Anaheim? Well, you left LA. But it's just so big. And, you know, I've said this before, the three lanes is not. LA is four lanes each way. And it's solid traffic most of the time. Of course, I haven't been to LA in 30, 40 years. For all I know, they have added a couple more lanes. I gotta pick a spot to rest, as I think I'm gonna have to sleep before I get there. I got a new track IR sensor. It's working really well. It's wireless. The track IR sensor that you get from track IR, this is a third party that I bought this from in Europe. Kids making money hand over fist with this, but now we're back up to 55. Anyway, with track IR, you get two sensors that you can get. The first one is just clips on a baseball hat, and not very securely. Oh, I gotta pull in. And it has three reflectors on it. So it's just a piece of metal, and it's got three reflectors on it. And I'm gonna call it a camera, because basically that's what it is. There's a camera that sits on your monitor, and it senses these reflectors, these three reflectors, and it triangulates where your head is. So it can follow your head movements. The camera can. But the problem is that with these sensors, since they're just reflectors, any bright light or sudden change in light, the camera can't see the sensors because it's not reflecting. So if you are in a room and you open a window and sunlight's coming through, it messes up your track IR. It doesn't work. So that's kind of inconvenient. So you have to kind of sit in a darker room, and you know, it's just kind of cheesy. So the other model clips onto your microphone boom, if you have one, on your headset. And it's very cheap. Although it's not cheap, it's expensive. But the darn thing breaks real easy. And it works a little bit different, and it's powered. So you have a cord that runs from your headset because it has to be powered. That's kind of inconvenient. So the one that this kid in Europe makes is also powered, but he made one that is rechargeable. So, and it hooks onto your headset via Velcro, a piece of Velcro. And it's really kind of cool. Switch gears here, because it's got three LED lights, and the LED lights are powered, correct? And so it doesn't matter what the light in the room is, it's always going to see those bright LED lights. So there's no foul up. The only thing that can go wrong is if something gets in between you and the camera. So, you know, that's not likely to happen, but unless a bird flies through the window. But anyway, it works really well. It doesn't hold the charge all that long, though. Depending on what you're doing and how often you're using your track IR, where I had my problem was with playing Elite Dangerous, because I hadn't played in well over a year. I think the game, I was a beta tester. I beta tested that game in 2014, so it's been almost 2 years. Or it's going into the second year. Whoa. Yeah, you're going to have to wait for me, buddy, because All right, come over. I'll give you a break. So I haven't played for the longest time, and so I decided to kind of take another look at it. They got a new version, or the new DLC, where you can actually land your ship on planets and stuff. And it's kind of cool. So I ended up playing like 6 to 8 hours a day. Getting back into it. And so I was just using the snot out of my track IR. And all right, now I'm stuck on a hill here. Damn it. Where'd he come from? I'm getting tired. Let's see if we can get in out of the rain here. It's not raining, that was just an expression. Well, you know, it's just about time to sleep. The sun's going down. You traffic can have to quit pulling out in front of me. So anyway, I got this new track IR. It's working really well. Really happy with it. And it's cheaper too. I mean, it's pretty cheap. It only cost me $50. Well, actually it cost me a little more than that, but because I had to pay for the shipping from Europe, but it's worth it. All right, this looks like there's a place to sleep just ahead here. I'm gonna have to pull in and do so. But it's about time. And it's about space. Yep, there we go. Yawning away. Watch some kind of a thing they were talking about, yawning, amongst other things. Things that are unexplained by science. Yawning was one of them. They still don't know why we yawn, what purpose it has. And it was kind of funny too, because they had this kind of a demonstration where they went out into the street and a couple of people started yawning, and they watched everybody else around them started yawning too, like it's contagious. It was hilarious. Did I miss my sleeping place? Let's see. I did. I passed right by it. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. There's another one right there. I'll have to watch for that one. Doggone it. Yeah, I'll have to watch for that. Okay, I'm speeding a little bit, but that's okay. I want to see if a cop will get me for 1 mile per hour over the speed limit. Oh, donuts. Oh, man, that's something you never see. Donut shop. Billboard back there advertising divorce. That's funny. We must be in Nevada. No, we're not. Still California. Look, it's a hot dog stand. Whoa! Yeah, I waited a little bit long on that one. Right in front of a cop, too. Almost slammed into that guy. How come he gets to go that way and we can't go that way? What's he doing? And I thought he was coming across at me. All right, now I gotta quit gabbing. Ooh, river. Quit gabbing and don't miss this sleeping place. I suppose it's just one of those dirt pads out there that you can kind of pull into. It is! All right, fine. We'll do it. There's no rhyme or reason where you're supposed to park here, so I'm just gonna pull in. Here we go. Good night. Now see, isn't that... Wait a minute, what's my driver doing? 429, good girl. We should be able to use our sleeper. That'd be kind of cool. All right, guess I don't need the lights. Lights, camera, action. Look, another yellow truck. Ever since I made my yellow truck, you see them everywhere now. I never saw a yellow truck before I made this. It worked that way in Euro trucking too. As soon as you bought a truck of a certain color, half the trucks on the road were that color after that. I can't see. Oh, shoot. All right, there we go. I don't want to hit a tanker. God, that wouldn't be very fun. Leaving Redding. Redding, California. Gotta love it. Yeah, you kind of pop over the Siskiyous, you come into Redding. Redding's still pretty high elevation. And there's a big truck stop. There was. I don't know what's there now. Like I said, it's been many, many years since I was on the road. Used to be a big truck stop. I'd pull in, get a little fuel. And that's about where I would catch a little shut-eye coming from Washington State on my run down to L.A. And I would sleep a little bit, then I'd get up and run again, and I probably wouldn't stop till I got to the Grapevine. Well, may stop, but I'm talking about rest, sleep. There were places that, you know, you'd be driving through, you'd be a little tired. I can't tell you how many times I'd be on the road and you just need to sleep, but you don't have the time. And, you know, you just pull over someplace. If you could find a place to pull over, like maybe a rest stop or something like that. And you'd pull over and just kind of lay back in your seat. You'd close your eyes and just kind of fall asleep. 5 minutes, 10 minutes. No longer. Start your truck up, take off again. Did that many times. You'd get a few more miles down the road, pull in another place. Wouldn't even shut the truck down. You know, I'd leave the truck running and just lay back, just sit back in the seat and catch about 5-10 minutes of sleep and off you'd go again. This looks dangerous. Whoa! Talk about snake bag. Snake? Almost took that sign out. Guys bobtailing. Look at that pretty lake. Pretty water, pretty water. This old desert's nothing without a little bit of water. Got some guy come back. Came west from the east. He was a big city boy. Came out to the farm. I grew up in the Yakima Valley, which is like this, you know, sagebrush and stuff. It's a little different, the ground here in California, as it appears in the game, is quite sandy, and so it's a light brown color. Where I come from, the dirt is dirt colored brown. Still desert, but pretty much central Washington. And this guy comes out from back east. He's looking around. Well, yeah, this land wouldn't be nothing without that water out there. Because we live by a canal. you get your water from the canal. There's a couple of big canals that run between rivers and stuff in Yakima Valley, and they're big cement canals that were built, and water flows through them all summer, and you pay a certain amount of money for the water, and you know, wherever your farm's situated, you have a pump that you set out, you pump water out of the canal, and you irrigate your crops or whatever you're needing the water. In our case, we had pasture land that we were irrigating, but I worked in orchards, and the orchards needed water, and so you'd dig a ditch, and the ditch would come from the canal, and the water would pump into the ditch. The ditch would run the length of the field, and you'd go out and you'd plow these little trenches wherever you needed water. And then you would take a siphon hose out of the bigger ditch that you dug that went the length of the property, and you'd use these siphon hose and just, you know, do a little bit of sucking and siphon water out of the little ditch that you made into the bigger ditch into the little ditches that you dug through your property, and the water would trickle down to the end of the field, and you know, about every 5 or 10 feet you'd put another little ditch. And depending on what you were watering, we were watering orchards, so we'd have a little ditch that went along each side of the trees, and that's kind of how we watered the fields. Now, later on in life, they put in sprinkler systems, but hey, you proud of me? I didn't miss my turn. Do we need fuel? I guess we'll be okay. Eureka! We're here. I thought I had discovered Eureka, but I guess I had not. There's another little place on the top of the mountain between California and Oregon called Yreka. It's way up there in the mountains. Little bitty place. Yeah, that's pretty funny.
Now this land wouldn't be anything if you didn't have water.
I kind of looked at me, so what the hell land would be if you didn't have water? I mean, really? Just because we had to pump it in, water's water. Hey, we're at Walbert's. Alright, where's our load have to go? Back that way. Oh, that's not bad. Hey, we got her made. Well, actuality, I didn't do too bad because I forgot I had a 13 speed. Didn't do too bad. Alright, let's see if we can get this thing into our slot without too much trouble. Probably could have went a little further over. Yeah, maybe that would have been a thing. Let's see here. These mirrors could do a little better, because I can't quite see where I need to line up. I think I'm over too far. Yeah, I'm over too far. Not by a whole lot, but enough. So let's
right, let's try that one.
Cut it a little bit here. Yeah, I don't think I went enough. But we'll back it in here, and then... Yeah, I didn't go enough. Doggone it. I'm really muffing this one up. Let's just... I still don't know if I went enough. Yeah, I'm okay. See, the problem is these mirrors are kind of weird. I can't, if I get a little distance away, you can't really tell what you're seeing. But we got her made now and just straight back, we're okay. And there we are. Okay, 569 miles, 24 hours, 16 minutes, 107 gallons of fuel. What was that? Long distance delivery bonus, skill rank 2. Oh wow, high value cargo bonus and a fragile cargo bonus. And we got a bonus for parking our own trailer. Wow. We got quite a bit in bonuses there for experience. That's good. And we made $14,000 to boot. Very good. I'm happy. Look, I'm a workhorse now. Okay. Well, I guess we ended that trip. So that wasn't too bad. I only screwed up a few times. Getting used to that 13 speed and getting used to talking and walking and chewing gum at the same time. So I hope you had fun, and I'll see you on the road in the next episode. Happy truckin'.